So here is a profile page. Okay, so when you come to my website and when you click on this about and click on this profile, this is how you get here. So in this profile page, I wrote everything about myself, from when I was born and how I went to the US and studied and survived. Basically, I ran out of money one time in the US, so I came back to Japan and saved money for a year, and I went to the US again to restudy and to finish the school. So there was a story behind, right? There was many stories behind, so I talk all about this. And ever after I came back to Japan from the US, I was a full-time trader. I was a full-time worker as a human resource on one of the IT companies in Japan. And after that, while I was working full-time, I started the Forex part-time first, and then I became a full-time trader. So I started to take trades since 2013. Up until now, I am a full-time trader now. So you see whole history here. So I will take bits and parts of this profile so that you know better about myself. Okay, so about K, right? I will just cover this part today. So about K, why did you become a Forex trader? So when I first saw the Forex chart in 2013, it was just fascinating, right? It was just fascinating, all these candlestick patterns and candlestick moves and the market moves up and down and buy, sell. All these were just amazing to me, right? I mean, these were like very interesting to me. So it says it aroused my sense of intellectual curiosity more than anything I have been seen in the past. So that's why, that's how I know about the Forex. And to talk about it more, my colleague at that time when I was working full-time was actually taking trades, and he introduced me the Forex world. So that's how I became, that's how I came into this Forex world now. And every detail of the chart and its tick movement, right, just so interesting for me, because it's something that I've never seen in the past before. And also, I have a dream to visit and explore different countries every 1 or 2 years. And there is a possibility to achieve the goal by Forex trading. So basically, you know, Forex trading or any trading, you just have to have a PC. Mobile PC will be okay. I mean, laptop will be okay. And mobile, if you have a mobile, you can still take trades too. I prefer to look at the chart on the laptop because I can analyze better. But when I take trades, sometimes I take trades on the mobile too, because I already analyze the market by the laptop. So yeah, but basically, if I have a secure internet and the, you know, good spec of a laptop, then I can just go around any place in the world and explore. 1 or 2 years, I go different places in the world and I want to see more and more. Different people, different traders, and different countries I want to visit. So that's my dream. That has been my dream before, and now it's becoming more realistic after I started the Forex trading. So that's my motivation why I started the Forex trading also. So and the start point will be in Dubai. So the visa issue is still in progress. So hopefully, if I get the visa and if the coronavirus situation is over, it will settle down a little bit more, then I will go to Dubai, and from Dubai, I will visit different countries. So that's my initial goal of my life. And Forex trading will be definitely a great job for me to travel around the world. Yeah, I want to see everybody. I want to see everybody who's on the chat box here. And also, I want to see anyone who writes me an email and who are joining Ichimoku members and who are in GTS class. I want to meet everybody face to face, possibly. And I can do that by doing the Forex trading or stock trading or any trading. So that's my dream and goal. And what is trading to you? Okay, what is trading to you? and forex trading is exciting and enjoyable, and it remains the same ever since I started, because I not only make money but also be able to learn psychology of other people, to look back my own mindset, to keep growing myself, and also to know the basic important factors in life overall. So this is another motivation for me and why I look at the chart every day. I look at the chart every day because I'm not really looking for the entry chance. I just look at the chart because I like to see the people's psychology. Whenever the price spikes up and spikes down, that means some loss cuts are happening, right? Or some buyers are buying, but at the same time, there are like a number of loss cuts accumulated, and that's why the breakout happens. So when I think about that, right, I take a buy, but on the other side, there are people who are losing. So this, which is quite interesting to me every time I look at the chart. So, and I learn myself. I take trades and I take journal. Every time I take trades, I take journal and I look back myself, my trades, and I learn a lot from myself, about myself. So I read the books recently I don't really read the books about the forex related, because I know that I have a good understanding of the market and all these theories of market. So, but rather I prefer to read more books about the, for example, like a poker's a player, professional players, poker or chess or a Japanese chess player. I read through these books. Or I like to read some athletes' books also, because I learn from their experience also, and I can apply their learning into my trading also, psychologically, mentally. So, and it's always a quite joy for me to notice something new about myself, and that's why I keep watching the market, and that's why I keep trading, because always, right? Every time I take trades, I learn something new. So that's why I take trades, and that is a trading to you, it's a trading to me. Okay, so I think the definition is different among traders, but that's my definition here. So I truly realize that life is all about learning. Okay, so and this learning is never ends, and that's why I also like about trading forex, because I run the Ichimoku community, and I read the book here, Ichimoku book. And when I read the book, for example, personally by myself and apply to the daily chart, it's still I learn a lot too. But if I start to explain things in front of people like this on YouTube, then I learn more about the market and learn more about the Ichimoku, and I learn more about myself also. So the learning process never ends. Whichever market or whichever professions you are at, the learning never ends. And yeah, definitely before and after the forex trade, for myself, I learned a lot more than before about myself after I started to look at the chart and take trades. So yeah, trading is truly the process of my learning. And yeah, that is the trading to me. Yeah, let's see. Let me come back to some of your comments. This is a very good forum. You teach so well and very clear. Sure. All right. Good to hear that. All right. We can learn so many things by visiting different countries. Sure. Yeah. Come to India. Sure, I will. I used to be in India, in Mumbai, for 2 weeks or 1 week. Yeah. When there was a Diwali festival, I went there and it was beautiful. So yeah, I want to visit India one more time, or more times. Yeah, I want to explore different countries, different cities, which will be very interesting. I never been to Europe, so I want to go Europe. I never been to Africa, so I'm gonna go there. Yeah, there's so many places I want to visit, and I want to talk about the forex, or I want to talk about the trading. So. Yeah, that's my goal here. Yeah, and that's why initially I went to the Los Angeles, because I was you know, there was an option, of course, to study in Japan. But maybe you know already, but in Japan, right, more than 99% are Japanese here, and we speak Japanese only. So the lectures are all in Japanese. Unless I take any English courses, all lectures are in Japanese. Almost everybody in Japan are Japanese. So there is no diversity here in Japan. So I thought it's boring. I want to see more and experience more. And that's why I went to Los Angeles. So yeah, and it's still the same. I'm still having that curiosity to explore different countries. So that's me. Welcome to Tanzania, sure. You are very welcome to come to Netherlands, sure. I want to visit Netherlands too, for sure, I will. India is more beautiful and exciting than other country. Sure, sure. Yeah, you take me around when I go there. That'd be great. I recently read the book by Vishwanathan Anand, world chess champion. Oh, okay, okay. Yeah, okay. Awesome insights by him. Yeah, I will take a look at it too. I will write it down and take a look at it later. Yeah, but these books are very interesting and very applicable in forex trading too. Yeah, I mean the psychology, right? Psychology is very important. How to cut the loss until when you push, from when you withdraw is very important. The mindset. Yeah, when to go for it, when not to go for it is very important. I am a great fan of Cristiano Ronaldo. Okay, okay. Great soccer player. In South India, okay. A lifetime is not enough to explore India. It's a very vast and beautiful country. Sure. I'm gonna go to South part, North part, and yeah, East and West. Sure. Come to Europe, I can take you around. I'm a tour guide. Oh, really? That's good news, Brandon. Alright. Yeah. Yeah, it's nice. For sure, I will visit. Yeah. And when you come to Japan, please let me know. Always. If I'm in Japan, I will take you around too. And we can have a cup of tea or coffee. Well, I don't really drink a coffee, so we can have a cup of tea. Yeah, in Japan. But yeah, that was a brief, a little talk about myself. So tomorrow, after the public live, there will be a membership live, Ichimoku membership live. So I don't think I will have enough time to talk about myself tomorrow. But on Sunday and Monday, except for Thursdays and Saturdays, when there is no Ichimoku membership live, then I will talk about myself a little bit so that you get to know myself more. So yeah, so there is a history of my profit, net profit here, and also there is a philosophy of my trading here, I put it, and also my educational career background, I put it here, all these. Timeline and the story, I put all these. So it was good exercise for me to look back my own history, so that and this is another way to learn myself too. You know, always look back yourself and learn something from it, and apply it now to grow in the future. So yeah, I used to live in a city called Sedona, Arizona. I was a tour guide there, so that was here also. Yeah, so there are so many stuff here. So if you have time, you can come here, my page, about profile, click on this one and you see all this information. So yeah, once again, thank you for joining today, everyone. Before ending this video, let me briefly remind you about the importance of patience. Patience is the key to success in trading. Whether you take trades in forex, stocks, or commodities, or cryptos, or whatever, patience is the key. And what I really mean by patience is the ability to wait until there is a trade chance. Trade chance will come and you just need to wait until then so that you can run profit over time. People cannot wait because they don't know until when they need to wait. But if you know until when you need to wait, you should be able to be patient until then. And the strategy is really there to know until when you need to be patient to wait for trading edges. If you liked today's video, please press the good button and make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so that you get notified as I do the next live or upload a new video. Wishing you a great trade success, and I will see you on the next live or video. I thank you always for your continued support, and stay gold. またね!